Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Start Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1686, Project Codename GeoFlow. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, today, April 11th, is the release of the next version of Project Codename GeoFlow, preview for Excel. All week I've been talking about this real estate data, and I use the tricks from Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday to actually get data, 50 years worth of sales data for over 2,000 homes in the Merritt Island. So we're going to map, launch GeoFlow. Now, lots of nice improvements to GeoFlow here, including some things that you would never really find, and I want to show those to you. I've had a chance to use GeoFlow for a couple of days here. First, you want to choose your geographic fields. So I have four of those. I have address, city, state, and zip, but my address is just street address, like 123 Main Street, and they want to map that to this new field called address. Never choose address, always choose street. Address is supposed to have the street, the city, state, and zip, and if you choose address, everything's going to get mapped incorrectly. Not everything, but a lot of things will get mapped incorrectly. Let's see, chart types, they now offer column, bubble, and heat map. Heat map is really cool, but I'm not going to show you that today. I'm going to choose bubble. For the height, I want to show the sales amount. The category is going to be allotment. And then the sale date is going to be time. All right, now, while I'm waiting for all this to load, let's take a look at some of the new things we can do. This little date decoration up here, I'm going to right click that and say edit. And they offer different ways to show the date. I really don't need to show the sale date down to the time. I don't even have that, of course. So I just show that as month and year. Click accept. I can make it a little bit smaller if I want, but make sure to leave enough room there for September or whatever the long months are. Here we have our different allotments, and I can resize this. Get all of the allotments in like that. So nice improvements there. Okay, let's also, we'll zoom in here. Remember, it's same as before, control wheel mouse to zoom in. Control wheel mouse. But I figured out something really interesting. If you want to tip the data, this should be an average in case there were two sales in the same month. There we go. Okay, if you want to rotate the data, I used to talk about holding down Alt and doing an arc. It's not the arc, it's the left and right. So if I want to rotate this data, just hold down the Alt key and drag directly to the left or directly to the right. Now, hand off of Alt, and we can bring the area back into view. If I need to tip, Alt and straight up or straight down will tip so I can get a different view of the data. All right. Now, some more things. Let's see, we have our layer one here, and we have the little cog next to layer one. They've now given us control. This might have been there before, I'm not sure, of the thickness. And see, each one of these columns ends up being about one city block. But since I have every house on the street, I might have 10 blocks per city, and they're all on top of each other. So we want to make these really, really small. Like 5% is actually a good way to go. That way, even if I zoom all the way in, I can see the individual houses. All right, so 5%, they got smaller. Also, we have a cog here on the timeline. And before, it was always going way too fast for me, so we can slow that down a little bit. All right, so here's some things that I was able to discover with this data. Our target area is this section of Merritt Island right here from 520 to 528. One thing I've learned though is Merritt Island is looking for a newer house, and frankly this whole area started to really go haywire back in the 60s when the Apollo program, because Kennedy Space Center is just right up here, when the Apollo program started, that's when we started to see the first homes pop up, so back in the 60s, and a lot of this area was built up, let's say, you know, by the end of the Apollo program in the 1970s. All right, now I'm going to pause this, and I can drag the scrubber here anywhere along the timeline. And so right here we're at April, or 1986, I'll zoom in a little bit. Oh, hey, here's another great thing. This theme, the second theme, actually replaces the map with a satellite image, so I can you know, actually see the streets and everything like that. So right here, look at these homes that are now there, were not built in 1986. So if Mary Ellen is looking for a newer house, you know, hey, let's go check out these streets. What streets are those? Okay, map labels, and we can zoom right in on that allotment. So leeward lane, Sykes Point Lane, Sykes Creek Drive, those might be some interesting places. And I can see when they started to build up, right there, around 1987. But I can hover and see 256,000. But there's some smaller houses there as well. All right, so we'll let this continue to go. And we can see as the area gets built up. So those are the newer homes, although I'll have to go check later and see how the prices are. The other thing that was really fascinating to me here is Florida real estate went crazy in the 2000s, and we can really see that as I drag the scrubber. So let's get right up to so there we are in 2000. Now watch how home prices just soared over the next several years, in some cases almost doubling or tripling. Now not every home was sold during that period, so they're not all sitting there practically underwater, but a lot of them are. There's a lot of inventory that was sold during that period, and we'll have to see what happens with those. So this is the new project codename GeoFlow. Certainly doesn't give me all the answers, but I can hover over any individual house, see the date of the sale, see how much it was sold for. I can see some of these really high spiky homes here that are the palaces that I'm never going to move in. I just need a home back here on the canal where I can throw my kayak in. So great way to visualize a data set. Again, 2,000 homes that we have here with 50 years worth of sales history, all that was scraped from the Brevard County property tax appraiser site using the macros from Tuesday and Wednesday of this week. If you have Excel 2013 Pro Plus, check out GeoFlow. Again, you can download it from the URL on the screen there. All right, there you have it. Thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.